the small town of Seaford, Delaware. Well, it's gained a national attention for a proposed bill that would have allowed corporations to vote in local elections. Here's an excerpt from the bill, which was introduced in April. Every owner of property in the city as of the day of final registration next preceding the annual election, whether a natural person or artificial entity, including but not limited to corporate partnerships, trusts, and limited liability companies, and who is registered to vote in the book of registered voters maintained at City Hall, shall have one vote. An artificial entity shall be a domestic entity in the state of Delaware and be in good standing. The bill would have given corporations, of course, huge amounts of power. Just 340 people in Seaford voted in the most recent election on April 15th, and the bill would potentially provide as many as 234 votes to the businesses in the community. And oh, by the way, corporations, of course, already have a lot of privileges in Delaware. The state is one of just a few that do not charge corporations income tax and allow corporation officers to hide themselves behind a vast web of secrecy. Delaware is also home to the 200-year-old Chancery Court, which presides over corporate disputes and helps give the state its pro-business reputation. Its business court has been a model for 25 other states, often delivering more favorable outcomes to corporations than regular district courts would. David Genshaw, the mayor of Seaford, supported the bill. He said, these are the people we're trying to attract to our community that we're asking to invest, to hire. Why wouldn't we give them a right to vote? I find it hard to believe. Who wouldn't want that to happen? These are folks that have fully invested in the community with money, with their time, with their sweat. We want them to have a voice if they choose to take it. Democrats control the Seaford legislature, and for a while, it seemed like they might actually pass the bill. State House Speaker Peter Schwarzkopf said in a committee hearing in May that he is kind of caught in a pickle here, he said. I don't think it's a good idea, but I don't think I want to vote to stop it.
Why not?
And thankfully, the story has a happy ending for now, at least for those of us who are of the sane minds. Here's what More Perfect Union reported yesterday, breaking: the Delaware House removed the Seaford LLC bill from its agenda and adjourned without a vote. A big win for democracy in the first state for now, but Delaware could go a step further and pass HB 189 to ban LLCs from voting in all local elections.
Okay.
Of course, House Bill 189 was introduced by progressives and would deny all corporations and other artificial entities the right to vote.
Yeah, an LLC is a corporation, and they can already vote in some elections in Delaware. That's cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. So I learned this during the Bush-Cheney years when we had to study torture because they started torturing people on behalf of America. It turns out that you've broken a detainee that you're torturing when you can get them to admit things that they know aren't true, that are obviously not true. Then they're broken and they'll tell you anything that you want. And that was actually the point. Dick Cheney ordered that kind of torture so they can get them to say false things about how Iraq attacked us when Iraq had not attacked us. The whole country is being tortured by our politicians and our media as they pretend these outrageous things are not outrageous. A corporation voting? Are you guys mental? What does that mean? Why the hell would a corporation vote? It's not a person. So by the way, some guy in Delaware. So remember, this was to make sure that all corporations could vote in all elections. And the Democrats said, oh, we're in a pickle. What? Wait, why are you in a pickle? Where's the pickle? Oh, that's because you're crooks and you get donations, i.e. bribes, from those same companies. They're like, oh man, I mean, they're obviously not human beings, and them voting is just nuts. But on the other hand, I'm a criminal and I take bribes from them. So, I'm in a pickle. I'm in a pickle. By the way, another guy, another politician from Delaware is Joe Biden. You know what Joe Biden's nickname used to be when he was in the Senate? There's tons of companies that register in Delaware. Credit card companies are enormous in Delaware. And in the old days, there was a credit card company called MBNA. Biden's nickname was the Senator from MBNA. Because he would represent credit card companies religiously. Law after bill after bill after bill to give credit card companies the ability to crush you and make sure that you can't ever get out of your debts. That's who Joe Biden is. That's how these Democrats in Delaware are, who are in a pickle. How about Republicans? 100% corrupt. They're all in favor of companies being able to vote. So since some of the LLCs can already vote in Delaware, some guy who set up 31 LLCs and got to vote 31 times. One guy voting 31 times, no, it's okay. It was one human and 30 corporations. Corporations are not human beings. Anyone who tells you that, including the Supreme Court, all the crooked politicians and all the crooked media, they're lying. They're gaslighting you to the point of torture. They are not human. They have no human rights. We are their creator. We can choose whatever rights they have. To argue that they have constitutional rights like free speech, which is now interpreted as completely and utterly allowing bribery, and now voting? No, no. I'm here to tell you, everyone else that pretends this stuff is normal is 100% lying to you, and they are part of corporate rule and corporate tyranny. This is madness. They're not at all human. And all they do is bribe our politicians and buy off our governments. That's the reality.
What more do these people who support LLCs and corporations having a vote, what more do they want than what they already have? As he pointed out, thanks to the Supreme Court saying that, oh yeah, corporations can give unlimited sums of money into our political process. They can bribe, they can corrupt, they can spend as much money through PACs, whatever. Whatever a corporation wants to spend, that's fine. There's no limits for PACs. And oh, by the way, maybe there's some limits in terms of direct contributions, but a lot of corporations don't give money that way. So what is it? What else do these people who support corporations want? What are you going to get from being able to vote and have a corporation vote that you don't already get through the amount of money, corporate money that is washing through the system and corrupting the process? It's just, it seems absurd to me.
David, I asked the same question. It turns out there is an answer. It's because they're in these small little towns in Delaware, and they want to strip the town from having the ability to regulate them at all. So it's completely lawless. And in those small towns, there's so many corporations that they could outvote the citizens.
Wow. So development, and they can say, let's get rid of the wastelands, yeah. Let's sort of build in areas, let's destroy things, let's not worry about, I don't know, environmental dangers or hazards to our citizens. Let's do whatever we can vote for. We take our vote and we suddenly say, oh yeah, we're gonna, you know, build those power lines, and we're gonna build that, you know, that power plant that may be dangerous and untested, and we're gonna put, you know, cell phone towers and all sorts of stuff that we don't really quite know the health hazards yet. We'll put that next to a school, because who cares? Because the corporations, those businesses want it, as opposed to the citizens who have to live their lives there. It's remarkable.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.